In this video, we will show how to set up an expression analysis. Expression analyses are a way to do calculations with AF attributes. Think about what calculations do you use your data for now, and then look at this as a way to do those calculations all within your Pi system. Let me give you an example. I'm looking at the AF database for this manufacturing group in Pi System Explorer. And they have different elements for their different pieces of equipment. And all their pieces of equipment, like this BP988, have an AF attribute for status, which describes whether or not the piece of equipment is running or it's down. Operations wants to be able to track for each shift what percentage of the time was each piece of equipment up and running. Let's set up an expression analysis to do that calculation. Expressions are configured for a given element using the Analyses tab. If you don't see this Analyses tab in Pi System Explorer, you probably aren't using the latest version of the Pi server, which includes AF 2.6, or you don't have the latest version of the client tool. But there are a lot of pieces of equipment in this AF database. There's just these four for this line, but there's multiple lines and multiple sites. And I don't want to set up that calculation for each individual piece of equipment. Fortunately, these equipment elements were built off of a template. So what we need to do is to set up the expression analyses only once on the template level. Go to Library, and then under Element Templates, there's this OEE Unit Template, which each piece of equipment is based off of. And you can see the status listed as one of the attributes of the template. For a template, analyses will be set up under this Analysis Templates. So let's navigate there. The steps are essentially the same, whether you're doing this on an element or a template level. We'll select Create a New Analysis. And the first thing that we're going to do is start over here on the right-hand side, giving the analysis a name and description. So as we talked about earlier, we're going to be looking for the uptime percentage for the equipment, and I'll give a full description. And for organizational purposes, I'm going to use my KPI category, since this is a KPI we monitor. Create and use your own categories that make sense for organizational purposes in your AF analysis. And the analysis type is left at the default selection of expression. Since we're doing this type of analysis using a template, one additional thing that we'll need to do is to have an example element selected. An example element is needed because the template itself doesn't have set attributes and values. Right now, one of the elements has already been selected, but I could change this by clicking on it and looking at, say, another piece of equipment if I wanted. The expression will be entered in this field down here, and there's a list of available functions here on the right. Let's take a look at these functions. So some of these functions are things that are probably pretty familiar. Things like operators, math, logics, and there's some that are specific to things like the Pi system, including those under the search and retrieval category. And you can use a combination of any functions to create a given expression. If you've used performance equations, you'll notice that these look very familiar. And if you're interested in seeing a list of all the functions, you could select all, and the full list is also available in the Pi System Explorer User Manual under the Expression Functions Reference section. The particular function we're interested in is under Search and Retrieval, and it's called time equals right here. And once I have this function selected, down below it will tell me what the input requirements are and what it will output, as well as an example. This particular function will find the total time within the given range when the point is equal to a given value. And this is what I'll need to use for my uptime percentage. I'm ready to start the expression, so I'm going to navigate here, click on this box. One thing I could do is I can insert this directly from here, or I can just start typing in time equals, and you'll notice that IntelliSense picks up the available functions and provides them for us. The next thing it does is that it tells us what the requirements are. So I'll need to do the attribute tag name, and also tells me specific syntax rules for expressions. For instance, the attribute name needs to be enclosed in single quotes. Okay, so I'll need to do the attribute name in single quotes. If I type a single quote, what it does is it pulls up all the attributes that are in that element. Now, if I was trying to use attributes that weren't in this specific element, then I could actually use this attributes tab to look in my hierarchy and find the ones that I'm looking for. I can add attributes from here, but in my case, I can just type it, since the attribute status is part of this element template. The next thing I'll need to do is to do the start time. I'm going to run this calculation at the end of my shift, and I want it to represent the entire shift. My shifts are 8 hours long, so I'm going to use relative time references and do the asterisk minus 8H. You'll notice I was using single quotes, just like the information stated I needed to do. And now I'll need to do the end time, and that also has to be in single quotes because it's a time reference. And finally, I'll need to do the value. Now, for the syntax rules, if the value is a number, like 80, I could type that as is. But my value is actually a string running, so I'll need to do that in double quotes. Now, I have this set up, and what this will do is it will basically be evaluating how long was the status running within this time period. But that's not actually my uptime percentage, which is what I really want. In order to get it into that format, I would need to divide by the number of seconds in my shift, and then I would need to multiply that by 100%. I can keep typing and do that, but one of the really nice options is I have the ability to do multiple expressions to give them variable names, and then they'll be evaluated sequentially. So that's what I'm going to do in this case. And this just makes it easier to see how things were set up and for debugging purposes. I'll give us a name of uptime seconds. I'm not really able to put spaces in the name, so I'll do it like that. And then my other expression, let's do the shift seconds, or the number of seconds in a shift. And let's see, my shift is 8 hours long, and then there are 60 minutes in an hour, and 60 seconds in a minute. And then I'll set up a final new expression for my uptime percent. In this case, I can actually use my variable names. And if I want, I can use the evaluate button to see what they would be at the current time for my example element. So I'll hit evaluate. And the next thing I need to do is say where I'm going to map this calculation to. So I could map any of my expressions, but I'm really only interested in the uptime percent output. So that's the only one I'll choose to map. So I'll click to map. And right now it gives me all the attributes in my template. However, I don't have an attribute for the uptime percentage yet. So what I'll do is I'll do the new attribute template. And I'll give my attribute certain properties. To keep things nice and organized, I'll choose the KPI category. And It's always good to set a unit of measure to keep track of things. And I'm going to keep the data reference as pie point and select the settings. One of the exciting new options is the ability to write the analysis outputs to pie tags and to have those tags created through AF using this tag creation selection option. It is actually highly recommended to store the analysis to pie tags so that you can historize the data, and it also improves the AF performance. And I can even set the attributes of the pie tag here. So I'll hit OK. And the last thing I'll need to do is to schedule it. When scheduling something, there are two choices: event triggered and periodic. Now, event triggered will trigger basically this calculation whenever the status attribute changes. If I had more than one attribute in my calculation, I could choose. But I'm really interested in having this calculation run at the end of my shift. So I'm going to do periodic because that's a clock-based scheduling. Select periodic and then choose the configure option. Now in this case, as I mentioned, my shifts are 8 hours, so I'll change that here. Once I have 8 hours specified, you'll notice that there's also this example evaluation times at the bottom. My shifts are at 8 hours, but they happen to not be at these precise times, so I'll use the specify offset option. So let's say my shifts start at 7 a.m., 3 p.m., and 11 p.m. For the sake of this video, in order for us to see the calculation actually occur, since it's 3:01 now, I'm going to slightly modify this time. So say these are the starts of my shifts. So I'll hit OK. And now I'm ready to check in my changes. Let's take a look at the elements. So under my elements, I can see that I now have this uptime percentage attribute. But there's a little bit of a strange message. It says pi point not found. So we had selected the tag creation option, but we still need to actually go ahead and create those tags. A fast way to do this in bulk for all of the elements would be to do a right click and do create or update data reference. And I'll check in this in. And now if I look, you'll see that my uptime percentage now says point created because the tag has been created, but we haven't written a value to it yet. But I'm thinking scheduling wise, that will change pretty soon. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit refresh. Okay, so you can see it is now 3:03 p.m., which is the start of my shift. So I've computed this for the end of my last shift. And this uptime percentage is now available for each equipment piece.